Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to get straight back in with Battle Block Theatre, and we're going to go into Chapter 2. Like I said in the last one, if there's a cutscene, I'll stop speaking. But I don't think there is right now. No, just jumping straight into Act 1, Scene 1 of Chapter 2. Oop, there's a gem there. Never mind. Oop. I got lucky there. And dead. Alrighty then. So it would appear I'm already struggling a little bit with this one, which makes no sense. How many dimes gonna die out of the same part? Apparently a lot. Right. Oh, toast. A lot of new things to take into consideration, and there's the exit. Right. Ah, not too bad. Like I said in the last episode, if you haven't seen the last episode, I'd advise seeing that before this. I won't be doing a completionist run this time through. Potentially in the future if there's enough want for it, but if not, then it'll probably just be the one through and then that'd be it. It's nothing against the game, it's just I don't feel as though I personally can do a completionist run. I'm not patient enough to play a game that many times. Right. Didn't even notice the spikes there. I'm dropped. Right. Gem. Okay. Nope. That ain't it, Chief. There we go. Feel as though that was everything for that one. An A badge. Ding. Not everything but the time, okay. So we've almost finished Act 1 already. You can never trust this game when it comes to stuff like that. Oop, I almost didn't say that. Right, so you just can't handle that. Right. So we're underway with this one. Not going that way. That was almost a mistake. Oh, why'd I follow? I'm just the big dumb, apparently. But nonetheless, we'll keep going. Oop, I didn't mean to hit that. There we go. I apologise for the empty silences between levels. I'm just very focused and trying not to die as many times. like I say, that's chapter one done. Time to go on to act two. I know I did. Alright, so another new mechanic right here. Push and pulls. So the push and pulls stay on the block where they're placed. So if you hold them in the air, they'll stay in the air. If you hold them on the floor, they'll stay on the floor. Oop. I didn't even know what I was doing there. Right, let's keep going. Learn from mistakes and don't go that way. So, if I do that, and then push that forward and do that. One more. There is. Boomerangs. I could have full on kicked him into that spike there. Don't know why I didn't. And done. And what is it today? Good. Ooh. Come on, there we go. So again, another new mechanic with these floaty bridges. Come to me, boat. Ah, I missed it again. I can't remember if you can kill yourself with your own items. So it's an explosive frisbee. I don't know if I could actually take myself out with that or not. That was just bad timing. These bubbles. There's no time for mistake. Oh my goodness gracious. Almost fell straight into the water there. There we go. Oh, I missed the gem at the end. Oh well. One never hurt anybody. Apart from that one person that did hurt. What a wonderful performance! Right, so chuck that up there, pull that back and chuck. Never mind. Put that there. Keep forgetting you can block these. There we go. And then we're out here. Oh, these cats are a nuisance. Alright, just both of you fall down. That helps me. Alright, checkpoint. Oop, that was close. There we go. All right. Trying so hard to remember this game as I go through it. It's like playing it for the first time again. There we go, and there's the end. Right. So, already on Act 3.
Find the gems and put them in your pocket. Then find the door and you can unlock it.
Nice little bit of rhyme there by Hattie. Come to me, flying beast. Yeah, let's not go for the yawn because I know that'll end up taking me out. Totally unnecessary, but I mean, it worked. Gem. May as well call this 100 ways to die. Answer my last question. I don't think you can kill yourself because that would have done it. That will definitely do it. No. Get out of this, please. There we go.
Marvelous.
So, scene two. One more to go. Quite see the point in that, but okay. Anyone watching this would think I've played this a million times. This is my second playthrough, I think, in total. Alright, I was wondering what those were doing. It was releasing the bolt for us to call. Yeah, we'll just end there and not going for another.
I bet you'll get an A if you do it again.
Maybe I will, but I'm not doing it again. bad. Am I not going to be able to make it? There's other ways around that. Such as that. Pull that out. Always get myself into those sorts of situations where you just can't avoid. Nope. Oh, I didn't even realize that one before. Of course I would jump into that, why not? And that, and that. Just get me out.
I've seen better and done better personally, goodbye.
So for those of you who don't know the art style, if you've ever played Castle Crashers, it's the exact same development team that does this. So that might explain some sort of understanding of the art style if you've never played this game. Where are we going? Oop. Go. Okay. I've messed something up already. There we go. Right. It would appear we out here. Whew, I got lucky there. Where are we going? Can't we get bullied by cats again? Because they're the arsehole of the animal world. One done. I went straight through the checkpoint. That's just fantastic. Portal. And straight in the water. Why wouldn't that happen? There we go. That's what should have happened the first time.
Up that deep.
Right, I run. I'm guessing there's a secret there. And there we go. Should be another cutscene coming up, so I'll go silent for a second.
Way to bite the bullet so far. You don't even complain about the prison food, which is shocking because that stuff tastes like doo-doo casserole with a side of butt salad. But best of all, your riveting performances have the theater bursting at the seams with excited patrons. And with all this extra cash you're raking in, the theater can afford some serious improvements and really start beefing up these horrifying shows of murdery death to appease the fickle crowd. So that's good. And what's the deal with Hattie? He just creepily looms around the theater all day. Look at him looming. It seems like he's been forcefully forced to manage this place. Well, it looks that way. He just sort of sits there, just as productive as one can be. Yep, living life to the fullest. Bo, slow down, buddy. Yes, sir. Full of salt and pep. Full of pee and vinegar. Overflowing with youthful energy. Say something, Hattie. Cat got your tongue? Shut up. You know, people really seem to be a precious and rare commodity in this strange part of the world. Seems our little boat wreck was a delicious gift from the heaven gods, and these bizarre cats are taking full advantage of us. What cruel fate left them to roam the grounds of this scary old theater, desperately ruling these bleak premises with an iron paw? And just how long have they been orchestrating this sinister scheme? I mean, avert your eyes, children. Avert them. There's bony people skeletons everywhere. Scary, right? Now, I'm no genius, but I definitely know how long it takes for a body to decompose. So this must have been going on for at least... Oh, wait, scratch that thing I said. So do you possess the courage to soldier onward and uncover the mysterious mystery behind this grim world? Or will your hilarious death screams be drowned out by the sound of your own hilarious death screams? We shall see. We shall see. We shall see. You see?
So with that being said, thank you all for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.